Today, we go back to the source. Last October on As It Happens, we told you about a Toronto police investigation based on complaints made by members of Canada's Roma community against broadcaster Ezra Levant. The complaints were about on-air comments made by Mr. Levant on his Sun News Network show called The Source on September 5th of last year. The segment in question was entitled The Jew versus the Gypsies. Last week, Ezra Levant apologized, but not everyone was happy. On Thursday, As It Happens, spoke with a member of Canada's Roma community. Then, the Sun News Network asked us for a chance to be heard. Kory is the vice president of the Sun News Network. We reached him in Ottawa.
Mr. Teneycke, why did Ezra Levant wait more than 6 months before apologizing for what he said about the Roma?
Well, Carol, the network actually made an apology shortly after that broadcast aired. So I guess from our perspective, we had already apologized once, but we felt that, especially in light of some of the things that were written in during our CRTC application process, that there was still a bit of a raw nerve out there that required maybe a little bit more explanation than had been provided initially.
And what did you hear in those CRTC applications? What kinds of remarks are you talking about?
Well, you know, a sentiment not dissimilar to what a representative of the Roma community provided on air for you last week, which was, I guess, a feeling that, you know, the apology that had been made was just not sufficient.
You're referring to Gina Csanyi-Robah, who spoke with last week about this. But she believes, as you know, that the apology only came because Ezra Levant is being investigated for hate crimes. You dispute that?
Well, I can only speak to why we made the apology. The reason we made the apology is because we truly regretted that this episode had gone to air. I think it was a bad attempt at humor and satire as opposed to how it came across, which is something I think it was a lot more hurtful to people of Roma ethnicity. So, the motivation is one of regret. You know, the reason we made an initial apology many months ago was for that purpose. And the reason that we made one, last Monday, was a part of our CRTC application. We've never heard anything from anyone associated with the government or police or any sort of investigative body with respect to the complaint that the Roma filed. With the Toronto Police Services.
You do know there was a police investigation, though.
Well, if you're telling me that, but certainly in terms of what we have heard, we've never had any sort of contact on that, and it was not part of the decision-making process in terms of moving forward with an apology.
Are you hearing for the first time from me that there's a police investigation?
Well, we've never heard anything from the police.
What's been reported in the paper and confirmed by a Constable Wendy Drummond, that was done last October. So,
right.
So that this is the first you're hearing of
it. Well, we'd heard that the police acknowledged that they received a complaint, but I think we're splitting hairs. We certainly haven't ever been called for any sort of questioning or given any reason to be concerned that that was something that was going to move forward. So, you know, if the question is, why is it that we apologize? Well, we apologize because the segment shouldn't have gone to air. And why give more explanation? Well, because, clearly the initial apology wasn't sufficient in terms of explaining why it was wrong.
You mentioned the CRTC application, and this is so people understand. Sun TV is in the midst of a bid to the CRTC to make Sun TV's network mandatory on basic cable. How important is that?
Well, I think it's quite critical for the network. It's sort of an existential question for us.
You've said elsewhere that this is live or die for us, that you are having, losses of $17 million a year at this point.
Yes, that's walking around money at the CBC, but it's a pretty serious number for us.
That's serious money for anyone. And then you would get about $18 million a year if you were able to get on the mandatory basic cable. Is that right?
Yeah, approximately.
I guess the timing here is even more interesting, though, isn't it? That Mr. Levant's apology was aired on the very day that Sun News Network filed its final application. Is that a coincidence?
No, it's not a coincidence. In fact, it's exactly what I'm saying. That, you know, we made an initial apology, you know, more or less immediately after the broadcast. And as a part of that license application, there's a public consultation period. So basically, Canadians from coast to coast can write in, and tens of thousands did, mostly in favor of our application, but some opposed. And coming out of that public consultation, you're asked by the CRTC to basically answer your critics and provide, you know, essentially answers to the questions or the issues that they've raised. And for, you know, a significant minority of people who wrote in, they raised the issue of the infamous broadcast on the Roma crime ring as something that was, you know, very concerning to them. And so we felt, you know, a more robust explanation was needed. So you'll note that it's referenced in what we submitted to the CRTC. It's something that, you know, the timing is not accidental. It's absolutely in correlation to that. I wouldn't dispute that characterization. I don't think it makes the apology any less sincere, either the initial one or the second one. But what the second one does is make sure that people understand that we understand what we got wrong and why it's a problem.
But if you were not in the midst of the CRTC application, would Ezra Levant have issued that apology?
Well, if we'd gotten 300 people or so had written us and said, you know, some months later that they were still upset about it, I think we would have. But, you know, those letters came not to us, but they came as a part of that public consultation. Whether we would have gotten them had that process not be going, I don't know. I guess one will never tell. But not surprisingly, Carol, we're not really in the business of trying to make people angry on that kind of basis. You know, we want to stimulate debate. We want to have a robust discussion of issues. We want to be entertaining and informative. And if we cross the line or make a mistake, we want to apologize for it.
But I guess it's either right or wrong what Ezra Levant said on the air. And if it's only a matter of an apology when you're in the midst of an application where you stand to make $18 million a year, it seems less sincere. Would you not agree?
But of course, Carol, we apologized many months ago. We felt, a broader explanatory apology was necessary at this point because people were still upset. So there's no rule that an apology has to be accepted, and whether it's sincere or not is something that people have to judge for themselves.
It is a code, though. The CRTC is looking to see if you comply with a code, that your program should serve to safeguard, enrich, and strengthen the cultural, political, and social fabric of Canada. That's their words. So racist
sure.
rants would not be acceptable under those rules, correct?
Well, I'm not sure that I would accept the characterization that you're giving to that. I don't think the intention was ever to be a racist rant. But the codes we apply to our broadcasting are the same that every broadcaster in the country adheres to. It's the Canadian Broadcast Standards Council codes, and we adhere to all of those. The complaints that have been brought forward on this particular case have not even been ruled on yet. So all of this is being done in advance of that sort of more formal process.
I just want to understand, do you believe that what Ezra Levant said was racist?
I don't believe that his intent was racist. I believe that it crossed the line. I think that there's a very important distinction between talking about something that a group of people have done that might share a common characteristic. For instance, you know, one can have a conversation about any one of a number of social issues where there is a common element, be it race or religion or even region. But to not apply some sort of motive or ill behavior across the board, and whenever someone does that, I think it's bad commentary. I don't think it's true. And irrespective of what one's motivation was, it's the wrong thing to do, and it's not defensible.
This is in 9 minutes, September the 5th. Here's some of the language. Gypsies are not a race. They're a shiftless group of hobos. They rob people blind. Their chief economy is theft and begging. For centuries, these roving highway gangs have mocked the law and robbed their way across Europe. There's no point in trying to help them. The social workers will just have their wallets stolen. That's not racist?
I'm not saying that it isn't racist, Carol. I'm saying that it's wrong, it's incorrect, it shouldn't have been said. And I don't think that the intent was one of spreading hatred. You know, you've quoted a bunch of things from a nine-minute piece. None of the nine-minute piece should have aired. Certainly the parts that you read should not have aired. And, you know, as I say, the apology is pretty thorough. You know, I'm not going to defend those words because obviously they're not defensible.
Why didn't you fire him? I would have been fired for saying that.
Whatever they thought my intention was, I would have been fired.
Why didn't you fire Ezra Levant for saying this?
It wasn't his intention, and I've known Ezra very well for about 20 years. There's not hatred in his heart. I think he was in a live television format trying to be entertaining while talking about a very serious issue, which is an arrest of 400 people in a crime ring. And, you know, he said some things that were not entertaining and they were not satirical, despite the fact that that might have been their attempt.
Mr. Teneycke, thank you for your time.
Okay, thank you.
Kory Teneycke is the vice president of the Sun News Network. We reached him in Ottawa. The CRTC will begin hearings on the Sun News Network's application to become a mandatory part of basic cable in Canada on April 23rd.